The question that I'm most often asked by individuals looking at photography as an area of collecting and starting collections, as it were, for the first time is, how do I know the photographer isn't going to make 1,000 copies of this image? Because after all, until the digital revolution, we were looking at negatives and wet dark rooms, and with the digital revolution, I guess you can say it's even easier to create photographic prints. But the fact of the matter is, like any marketplace, the photography marketplace conforms to the law of supply and demand. And any photographer, any agent, any dealer is very mindful of the fact that it's important to restrict supply, because that is where demand kicks in. And what you have is a tiered kind of price structure. So in photography, that translates as the vintage print, the photograph made near the time that the negative was created, has the highest value, typically. Then we have what's called the modern print, which is a later interpretation from that same negative. Could be made 10 years, 20 years, even 30 or 40 years after the negative. The posthumous print, the photograph made after an artist has passed on, typically has little or no value. There's a sense that it doesn't have the authentication of the artist's hand, of the artist's vision, if you will, since photographers do sign their works to indicate that they're satisfied aesthetically with the finished product. An extraordinary example that we sold last week was Ansel Adams's Moonrise over Hernandez, which may be one of 1,600 different photographic prints of that image. So we are distinguishing between the image that we see on postcards, on posters, in newspapers, and the actual photographic print that Ansel Adams went into the darkroom and created. What collectors want, what curators want, is the photographic print, which is to say the interpretation of that negative.